355. Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts with the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Our Lord, who in these holy mysteries gives us the pledge of eternal life, and who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the readings.
Reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall mark for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month they are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportion to the number of people who eat it. Your lamb shall be without blemish, a year old male. You may take it from the sheep or from the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. Then the whole assembled congregation of Israel shall slaughter it at twilight. They shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and the lintel of the houses in which they eat it. They shall eat the lamb that same night. They shall eat it roasted over the fire with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. Do not eat any of it raw or boiled in water, but roast it over the fire with its head, legs, and inner organs. You shall let none of it remain until the morning. Anything that remains until the morning you shall burn. This is how you shall eat it, your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand. And you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. Throughout your generations, you shall observe it as a perpetual ordinance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. today's psalm is Psalm 116, which is found in your leaflet. We shall read it responsively by half verse. I love the Lord because he has heard the voice of my supplication.
Because he has inclined his ear to me whenever I call upon him.
How shall I repay the Lord?
For all the good things he has done for me.
I will lift up the cup of salvation
and call upon the name of the Lord.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord.
In the presence of all his people.
Precious is the sight of the Lord.
Is the
death
of his servants.
O Lord, I am your servant.
I am your servant and child of your hand. You have freed me from my bonds.
I will offer you the sacrifice of thanksgiving
and call upon the name of the Lord.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord
in the presence of all his people.
In the court of the Lord's house.
In the midst of you.
The second reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 to 26. I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Took off his outer robe and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the apostles' feet and to wipe them with a towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not only my feet, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "The one who has bathed does not need to wash, except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all you," for he knew who was to betray him. "For this reason," he said, "not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet and put on his robe and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done for you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you. Very truly, I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them. Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify in himself and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. You also should love one another. By this everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
This is a wonderful night as we celebrate Maundy Thursday. And tonight we are gathering as churches of St. Thomas, St. Joseph. Is there someone from St. Elizabeth?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So we are gathering as a trinity of churches. So I'm going to preach a three-point sermon. Members of St. Joseph Church know that I am a three-point preacher, and they know the three reasons why. First, because I am a Trinitarian. Believe in one God in three persons. Second, because I am the third child in my family. And they say that the most that people can remember in a sermon are 3 points. So it is a great pleasure to work with Father Chris. Father Chris and I have been very good friends for a long time. There is nothing that I will not do for him. And there is nothing that he will not do for me. Up to now, we have not done anything to each other. Only today that we are going to have a partnership here in ministry. So this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. What is Maundy Thursday? The word Maundy comes from the Latin word mandatum, which means a mandate or a command. Actually, the proper name should be mandata, as plural, because there is not just one command, but three commands that the Lord Jesus Christ said to his disciples on Maundy Thursday. And these three commands are: wash one another's feet, number one. Number two, love one another as I have loved you. And three, remember me. First, the foot washing command. Jesus surprised his disciples when, at the meal was being prepared, he stooped down and put towel on his loins and began to wash their feet. Now, foot washing is not and was not the task of a master. It was the task of the servants, in fact, slaves. And so Peter was embarrassed, and he protested, "No, Lord, you shall never wash my feet." Probably he had the dirty feet, or probably his fisherman's sandal has already been worn out. But Jesus replied, "Unless I wash you, you have no part in me." And Peter then replied, "So then, Lord, if that's the case, not just my feet, but also my hands and my head. OMG, Peter needs a bath." Now, joking aside, the washing of the feet is the lowest act of service. And by washing their feet, Jesus demonstrated that his leadership, his lordship, is not one of domination. It was of humility. It was not one of power. It was one of service. St. Paul remarked in his letter to the Philippians, though he was God, he did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself. Taking the form of a servant and being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on the cross. Now, earlier, there was a dispute among the disciples who was the greatest. And James and John, the sons of Zebedee, which the Bible also refers as the sons of thunder, because they are young and passionate, they asked their mother to intercede for them and to ask Jesus, "Lord, when you come to your kingdom," because they thought that he was going to have a, you know, magnificent kingdom like the kingdom of David, "when you come to your kingdom, let my children, my sons, sit on your right and on your left." So there was a kind of a bribery going on. But when the other disciples heard about it, they also got mad. They got upset because they too wanted to be in the same position, in the same place. But Jesus said to them, "You know that the rulers of this world lord it over their people. They dominate their people. But it is not so among you. Instead, let the greatest among you become like the youngest, and the leader is the one who serves." You know, a few years ago, when I was serving as National Missioner of Asia America Ministries in the Episcopal Church Center, and that's how Chris and I met, I came along. We were invited to China by the Chinese government. I came along with bishops and several VIPs of the Episcopal Church, professors and others. Now, they tendered to us an imperial banquet. Now, by the way, in the imperial banquet, they have a Chinese menu, a food. They call it in English, it says, "Buddha jump over the wall." That's the kind of recipe. Now, it is because the food is so fragrant and so good that when the Buddha smell the food, he jumps over the wall to come to your table. That's the Chinese, the one of the best food of Chinese, and they serve that during imperial dinner. Now, at that dinner, the Chinese protocol officer thought I was somebody because of my title as Asian American Missioner, as National Asian American Missioner. And there was a Reverend Canon Doctor before my name. So he thought that I was somebody. So he seated me beside the celebrity who was Bishop K.H. Ting of China, Chinese Christian Council. At first I felt awkward, but when the TV cameras began to roll, we saw my picture beside the celebrity, and to the envy of my other companions. I was not the celebrity, but because I was seated near the celebrity, they thought I was also a celebrity. So I could understand why James and John wants to be seated beside Jesus, because Jesus was the celebrity. Now, that's what they call photo bombers, right? You know, there is a celebrity there and you're not part of it, but you run when the camera rolls and then you are caught by the camera and you're a photo bomber. But Jesus said to them, shattered their myth about his lordship and said, do you understand what I have done for you? You call me master and lord, but I washed your feet. You should also wash one another's feet, because the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many. Amen?
Amen.
Second mandate, love one another. In John chapter 13, which we just read, Jesus said, a new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you. By this shall all men know that you are my disciples, if you have love one for another. The brightest mark of Christian is love. Love is our calling card. Love is our passport. Love is our identity. And they'll know we are Christians by our love. By our love. And they'll know we are Christians by our love. You know, I think these are times when we as Christians need to emphasize this second mandate. According to Wikipedia, there are 1,225 hate groups that are active in the United States alone. Multiply that with 200 countries and you realize that what the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. So Christians must be people of love because God is love. And Christ came into the world not to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through his love. It was love that Jesus gave himself, and it was love that he willingly suffered. It was love that he bore our sorrow and pain, that we might be forgiven. He was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that made us whole, and by his stripes we are here. We are here because of God's love. Amen?
Amen.
Third, remember me. At the Passover meal, Jesus took the bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Then he took the cup of wine, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Whenever you drink it, remember me. As the Passover meal symbolizes the liberation of Israel from slavery of Egypt, the Holy Eucharist is our liberation, is our Passover from death to life. Dying, he destroyed our death. Rising, he restored our life. From generation to generation, the Holy Communion has been the central point of our communal life. St. Paul wrote in 1 Corinthians 11, "For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." So we say, Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. So my friends, tonight, when you take the Holy Communion, which is in the last before tomorrow, we have a Good Friday celebration, we would have no communion. This is our Last Supper for now. I pray that when you take the Holy Communion, you may remember Jesus. I pray that you may see Jesus. For Jesus alone can truly answer your deepest needs. Jesus alone can truly mend your broken hearts. Jesus alone can truly wipe the tears from your eyes. Jesus alone can heal you and make you whole. Jesus alone can give you abundant life on earth and in the life after eternal life. My friends, remember Jesus. Not your sins, not your guilt, not your shame, nor anything else in the world. Remember Jesus and his love, Jesus and his compassion, Jesus and his care. Remember Jesus and his mandata. Serve one another, love one another, and remember me. Amen. So we're going to do foot washing now. Is it in the bulletin? Okay. There's a few people. 274. On page 274.
Page 274, Book of Common Prayer. Please stand. Lord Jesus, after he had supped with his disciples and had washed their feet, said to them, "Do you know what your Lord and Master have done to you? I have given you an example that you should do as I have done. Peace is my last gift to you. I give you a new commandment. Love one another as I have loved you.
Peace is my last gift to you.
My own peace is my last gift to you. Peace is the world
cannot give. I give to you.
By this shall the world know that you are my disciples, that you have love for one another." Please be seated.
We will now have a foot washing. Any one of you who would like to your foot washed, you come over here and sit on here, and Chris and I will be doing both sides of the washing. And we also need assistance to help us with the
towels.
With the towels.
Any volunteer?
You may come forward. You may sit here and put your coat on the mirror.
Yeah.
symbolic. And new commandment that I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you. Life for his friends.
You are my friends if you do what I command you. Love one another.
Walk in love as Christ loved us, and he gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God. Offer to him 315.
Amen.
are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness and mercy you have this bread and wine to offer, which all has given us and human hands have made. They have become spiritual food. Blessed be God forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For our sins he was lifted up high upon the cross, that he might draw the whole world to himself. And by his suffering and death, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who put their trust in him. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with the angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension. We offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit, to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament,
and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thank you.
and St. Thomas at 6:30 p.m. And
my God, why have you forsaken me and are so far from my cry and from the words of my distress? Oh my God, I cry in the daytime, but you do not answer, by night as well.
So
I find no rest. Yet you are the Holy One, enthroned upon the praises of Israel. Our forefathers put their trust in you. They trusted, and you delivered them. They cried out to you and were delivered. They trusted in you and were not put to shame. But as for me, I am a worm and no man, scorned by all and despised by the people. All who see me laugh me to scorn. They curl their lips and wag their heads, saying, "He trusted in the Lord. Let him deliver him. Let him rescue him if he delights in him." Yet you are he who took me out of the womb and kept me safe upon my mother's breast. I have been entrusted to you ever since I was born. You were my God when I was still in my mother's womb. Be not far from me, for trouble is near, and there is none to help. Many young bulls encircle me. Strong bulls of Bashan surround me. They open wide their jaws at me like a ravening and a roaring lion. I am poured out like water. All my bones are out of joint. My heart within my breast is melting wax. My mouth is dried out like a potsherd. My tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth. And you have laid me in the dust of the grave. Packs of dogs close me in, and gangs of evildoers circle around me. They pierce my hands and feet. I can count all my bones. They stare and gloat over me. They divide my garments among them. They cast lots for my clothing. Be not far away, O Lord. You are my strength. Hasten to help me. Save me from the sword, my life from the power of the dog. Save me from the lion's mouth, my wretched body from the horns of wild bulls. I will declare your name to my brethren. In the midst of the congregation, I will praise you. Praise the Lord, you that fear him. Stand in awe of him, O offspring of Israel. All you of Jacob's line, give glory. For he does not despise, nor abhor the poor in their poverty. Neither does he hide his face from them. But when they cry to him, he hears them. My praise is of him in the great assembly. I will perform my vows in the presence of those who worship him. The poor shall eat and be satisfied. And those who seek the Lord shall praise him. May your heart live forever. All the ends of the earth shall remember and turn to the Lord, and all the families of the nations shall bow before him. For kingship belongs to the Lord. He rules over the nations. To him alone, all who sleep in the earth bow down in worship. All who go down to the dust fall before him. My soul shall live for him. My descendants shall serve him. They shall be known as the Lord's forever. They shall come and make known to the people yet unborn the saving deeds that he has done.
We need some of the volunteers to clear everything on the altar.
Psalm number 51 on page 656. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your loving kindness. In your great compassion, blot out my offenses. Wash me through and through from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight. And so you are justified when you speak, and upright in your judgment. Indeed, I have been wicked from my birth, a sinner from my mother's womb. For behold, you look for truth deep within me, and will make me understand wisdom secretly. Purge me from my sin, and I shall be pure. Wash me, and I shall be clean indeed. Make me hear of joy and gladness, that the body you have broken may rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me the joy of your saving help again, and sustain me with your bountiful spirit. I shall teach your ways to the wicked, and sinners shall return to you. Deliver me from death, O God, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness, O God of my salvation. Open my lips, O Lord, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. Had you desired it, I would have offered sacrifice, but you take no delight in burnt offerings. The sacrifice of God is a troubled spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Be favorable and gracious to Zion, and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Then you will be pleased with the appointed sacrifices, with burnt offerings and oblations. Then they shall offer young bullocks upon your altar.